Welcome to Plants vs. Zombies episode 2. I am your host, lostwolfe. And I made a decision during the week that we weren't playing. And that is, we're going to play for 5 levels per episode. It doesn't matter how long that takes. So, what we've got here is our new plant, which is the potato mine. And I'm going to show you that because I want to show you more or less what it looks like when you get an achievement. So, hopefully, there we go. Okay, so he's on this row, we're going to stick it at the back here, and we're just going to keep on playing, planting sunflowers. Because that's the right thing to do. And he's going to... The potato mine is now armed. And as soon as he steps over it, he is going to die. There we go. And that's what it looks like when you get an achievement. Plays a little sound and then you get the text that refers to achievement. I'll show you what it looks like once we're done with this level. In the achievements center thing. Alright, so as always, we're trying to build our 2 lanes of sunflowers so that we can. But I'm trying to keep 100 open all the time so we can go right ahead and just plant the pea shooters as necessary. Right. That's good. Now, I'm going to put one here. Oh, well, that was the wrong choice. Of course it was. Okay. Yeah, that solved that problem. Okay, and now we're all good. I'm going to wait to see where the next zombie shows up, so there we go. Oh boy. That's bad. Yeah. Those guys can potentially, like they're doing now, jump over. And that's a bit of a problem. They run pretty fast until they get to the point where they're gonna jump over. Yeah, that was not good at all. Because my, walnut wasn't actually ready yet. Uh-oh. Oh boy. Solved. Uh-oh. Let's solve that issue quickly. Now what we're gonna do, I'm gonna pick this plant up, and then I am going to plant him right back where he was supposed to be. Because that's a gap in our defenses. Sounds good. This game can get a little bit frantic if you're not watching carefully. And that can be a little bit of a problem sometimes. But as long as you have your wall, you should be mostly okay. Oh, that's a final wave. We'll do this. And probably this. There we go. Because that running guy could have been an awful, awful issue. That should sort out the level. Because now this guy's got a walnut to munch on. And he will get stuck. And all will be good. Right. Just proving that I should have been building sunflowers like way at the beginning and not explaining so much. This is the snow pea. It shoots frozen peas that damage and slow the enemy. This is very good for us. Because it means that things on rows will be a little bit slower. There isn't anything new here. We are going to have to make walnuts again because there are running guys in our list of zombies that are going to attack us. So that's sort of bad. But with the pea shooter, Sorry, with a snow pea. It slows them down, so it's not really that big of an issue. Okay, let's do that. Mostly just so that I... because that costs 25 sun. So, it's a good first measure when you're starting out the level. And this way I can stick to being at or near 100 all the time. There we go. Oh, well, that's a bit of an issue. We'll just wait until the Plato mine has been expended, and then we'll put down our pea shooter. There we go. Oh, we have to do that pretty quickly. Hopefully that shoots the zombie before it becomes a problem. Okay, good. Alright. Sometimes when they come on a line like that, it can be a bit of a problem. Sometimes you get lucky. I just happened to plant a potato mine there, and that was a bit of an issue. It meant that I couldn't exactly plant my pea shooter right then. Okay, let's see if I can get a second pea shooter out there. And speed that along. Good stuff. There we go. Now it's just down to placing pea shooters. Okay, what I'm gonna do is this. And then do it again. I like when we've got a setup like this, I tend to like putting the snow peas out front where I would have put the walnuts before. Because that means that you're shooting three peas at them, and that tends to help quite a bit. Uh-oh. Okay, good. That was almost scary. In fact, let's just do that so you can see the snow pea in action. I don't think the snow pea does more damage than the regular pea shooter. It just slows them down a little. Okay, now you can see there, he is slow because the snow pea keeps hitting him. Alright, that's great. And we're gonna keep on doing... oh, goodness. We're gonna keep on doing that. All of these rows. And this is more or less a perfect defense for this level. I'm gonna try and get a... there. I'm gonna try and get more walnuts onto some of the rows. But the walnuts, as you can see, they recharge very slowly. So their cooldown is pretty long. And in fact, that turned out not to be a problem in the end. So now we're just gonna fill in the top, I'm gonna fill in walnuts. And that should be us sorting for this level. Because with a three-piece defense, there really isn't that much that can get through that. What am I doing? Oh, by the way, I didn't mention this, but if you've got a plant, and you don't want to plant that plant, you can right-click, and when you right-click, it basically turns your cursor back into a regular cursor. Which is important, because sometimes you don't want to plant what it is that you're busy sitting with. I had the snow pea there, and I really wanted a walnut. But this should be good. It should repel the final wave quite handy. I may need a cherry bomb just to thin out the numbers, but I think it should be okay. Come on. I just want to make two more walnuts. How difficult can it be? It isn't necessary, but what I'll probably also do is plant a lot of potato mines. Actually, let's get going with that plan. Although, I very much doubt anything's going to reach there. Unless it's a severe horde of zombies. And their defenses just get overwhelmed. So as you can see, like I said, some things recharge very slowly. The wall mine and the potato mine recharge very slowly. And some things like the pea shooter and the sunflower, they recharge pretty quickly. Like here, I would have used a cherry bomb right there. But I don't think there's gonna be any point. Well, maybe they will, in fact. No. It's gonna be okay. Cause he's only just gonna make it to the potato, the walnut. Ah. These guys are pretty effective. This is a chomper, it devours a zombie whole, but is vulnerable while chewing. So, these guys can take out any zombie at all, right? Like, we've got a new guy here. This is a buckethead zombie, and that's a Conan zombie. These guys take almost double the amount of hits that these guys do. So, the chomper is very good for getting rid of them. But then, while it's basically dealing with something, it is vulnerable. It's chewing, and so the other zombies can behind it. Can get eating on it. So, we need to make sure that we can deal with this guy. So here we have a new thing. We've got more seed packets than we have spaces. So we need to pick our plants carefully. So what we're going to do, I'm going to pick that. In fact, no, we'll pick. Let's do this. I tend to like arranging mine from least to most, because that way it's easy to see at a glance where I am. And then I think what we'll do is we'll take that and that. Yeah. This may be a bit of an issue because I'm not taking walnuts, but I didn't see any jumpers, so... That is good. If there were jumpers in the list, I'd be a little more worried, but as it stands, there are none. And so, that makes it not nearly as necessary to put down walnuts. Yeah. Oh, I planted that in the wrong row. Although, it's not actually worth getting rid of it now that it's there. I am just gonna... Let's see, what are we gonna do about the situation? Yeah. There. That is what we'll do. We'll get started early on pea shooters. I'm not gonna dig that up, purely because it could still be useful in the future. Yeah. I was sort of thinking about putting more sunflowers down, but... It's more important that I kill the zombies at this point. Alright, let's see, what do we have? Okay. We've got a zombie over there, and we're just gonna keep on making pea shooters. Alright, so now all my rows are covered. What I'm gonna start doing is, I'm gonna start making a second row. A bit early. Yeah, we'll deal with you. Now, what it makes the most sense to do, I'll just kind of show you the setup, is put the chomper here, and there you see the chomper in action. And let's keep going with that over here. And then we'll put a snow pea on the outside, because that way, oh goodness, that is bad. I need 50 more seconds. Yeah, there we go. And then we'll put a snow pea outside that to slow them down. This guy takes a lot of hits to kill, so I want to get rid of him as soon as I can. What do we have? We have regular little zombies, okay. And this is the first guy that we've had on this row. So, our potato miner's going to be fine for him. I noticed that this plant, the chomper, has finished dealing with the zombie that it had. And so, as a result, it's ready to go and deal with more zombies. This is turning into a legitimate bit of a problem, so we're going to go and bomb this guy. Okay. There. Problem solved. We need to put down more sunflowers. I've been lacking in that. Oh no. Let's cover that. And now, all we need to do is build up our defensive chompers. Oh, final wave. Really? Okay. There's nothing scary in the final wave, though. That's good. Oh, wait. You know what? There's a bucket head. And we'll slow him down. That was kind of the defense I was going for. Hopefully, well, it won't, it isn't, he's going to eat the snow pea. Yeah, he is. Oh, alright then. And this is probably one of my favorite plants, the repeater. Instead of firing one pea, it fires two, so you can make your lawn defense a little bit more elegant because of it. So we are gonna take the potato mine, I'm inclined to take that as well, and another panic measure, I think. Yeah, and then we'll do that and that. That looks good. So now, instead of planting two rows, I only have to plant one row of pea shooters, because they repeated will take up their place. But now, because they cost 200, you have to be very wary of how much sun you have. Because, for example, you're not going to be able to deal with the first couple of zombies. Where is he coming from? There. Okay. Yeah. And you want to keep your potato mine ready for the first couple of zombies, because you're going to be needing it so that you can get through the level. You want to make lots of sunflowers very quickly. And that's sometimes a little bit tricky, but we'll see what we can do. Okay, we have a second zombie. Good stuff. We'll arm a second bomb. And we should be okay. Yeah, we're in a position now where now we're going to try and stay at 250 so that we can always plant a repeater if we need to. I was actually terrible, you know, and I didn't actually see what was coming on the zombie screen, which is going to be a bit of an issue. Oh well. Okay, so let's plant a repeater. And as you can see, it does exactly what it says on the tin. It will shoot two peas instead of one. And that makes your defense a little more elegant, because now, instead of planting two pea shooters, you just plant one repeater. And it does, you know, the work that two pea shooters would have done. Okay. What do we have? We've got a guy up there. Okay. No problem. I'm just gonna go ahead and fill another 2 rows because it doesn't make sense to just wait and see what we get. We're so close to filling them in anyway. I tend to still build that second row outward, mostly for the speed it gives me in dealing with zombies, so I will end up filling in another row of repeaters over here. But realistically at this point, you know, you're all set if you just want to put down walnuts. Oh, I didn't realize there were jumpers. Oh dear. Thank goodness I took the walnuts. Otherwise that would have been sort of bad. There we go. Dealt with. Let's see. Once we finish making that, I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to pick up the walnut, actually. Because that was just a temporary measure to deal with the jumper. We'll pick up the walnut and put snow peas in. To slow people down. Although, at this point, we should be okay for the most part. It's just jumpers that I worry about now, because they can hop over our defenses, but we'll make sure that we always have the walnut open and ready to defend ourselves with. Oh. Goodness. Walnut right above there. And that's kind of what I like doing on this level. There we go. And now, nothing will probably get through, so that's good. I say that, but it doesn't always work that way. I would like 50 more sun, thank you. There we go. And now the runners won't even hit the walnut, and we're all sorted out. Because that's always a problem. The runners run very fast, and if you don't slow them down, they can become a bit of an issue. I need a little more sun so I can put a snow pea down here. Come on, son. You can do it. There we go. I think we will get... yeah, there we go. We'll get rid of that guy before he gets too close. That was a bit scary, actually. Not that we need them anymore, because we should be able to repel most of the zombies, but I'm going to stop putting down the walnuts. That's just an added layer of insurance in case something happens that I don't foresee. Come on, walnut. Recharge faster. Slow recharge things are a bit of an issue to me, because it means that what you have to do, in effect, is you need to be planting well in advance so that the recharge timer can go a little faster. That's not... You won't see that being especially crucial now, but doing some of the later levels becomes a very big part of the gameplay. You have to keep on planting so that you can keep your recharge timer going. Okay. Level 110. Hello, we're about to launch an all-out attack on your house. Sincerely, the zombies. I don't see anything but jumpers there that worry me. Oh, okay, they're gonna give me a conveyor belt. Conveyor belts can be terrible in the sense that they can sometimes not give you what you need. Like at the moment, I am, the repeater there. Although, the repeater really should have gone here. Pea shooter is good. And a snow pea is good. We'll put the snow pea out here. I should put it there. You should, oh, repeater. There's no set plan for me for this one. I'm just gonna put repeaters out here and hope for the best. There we go. And we'll put that over here. I'm gonna hang on to that because the sword jumpers. A repeater. Very good. I may actually need the... Okay, there we go. Let's make him jump into, because he'll jump over that. And we'll get him to jump over and hop into the bomb. Oh dear. Okay. Let's get going with more of these. What I really kind of want to do is I want to build two lines of repeater, so I really shouldn't have been building anything. Put that there, and then pick it up. Make more space in the conveyor belt. You know what? We'll actually do this. I don't really want peaches. So my plan to keep the conveyor belt moving is to build something expendable and then pick it up. Yeah. That's kind of good. That's kind of what I want. A pea shooter. I don't want that. And then I'm going to start, as these guys reach here, we will start planting walnuts. Oh, repeater. Very good. And another repeater. You can tell the repeaters from the pea shooter because the repeaters have two little tails. Okay, pea shooter, we don't need that. Let's put that down. Put that down. We can in fact pick these guys up now because we've got two more of us. I do kind of want to pick these up, but I'm not going to yet. Oh, now I am. There's your repeater. This is probably not the best idea I've ever had. No, it isn't, because I'm just digging up all the defenses there. There we go. Oh, it's a jumper. Is he gonna make it over? No. There. That's great, now we're all set up. So much so, in fact, I'm gonna start digging these up. Putting down walnuts. Repeater, don't need that. Don't need this. You can probably tell that I'm saving these up for a rainy day. Don't need that anymore. That'd be good there. Oh, goodness. You come, I do want you, however. That's good. More walnuts, where are you? Oh boy, that could get scary. Oh no, it'll be fine. I was a bit worried by that because I thought that he was gonna break through. But evidently no such luck on his part. I shouldn't really be putting that there because I can miss the... I should put that here. That conveyor belt moving. Oh. Oh, that might actually be a problem. Come to think of it. Yeah, it might actually be a problem. Yeah. And then what we'll do is put this guy here, this guy here. And I can eat them. That's fine because it will slow them down if they're eating them. Whoa! Okay, no, that's not a problem. I have to replace the walnut over here, though. It's getting a little bit bruised. There. I should plant things up here that the zombies can eat, because that will slow them down. And I can sometimes be effective and help you. I think this is about where we're gonna end it, by the way. Not a very frantic level, but, you know. Oh, hey, they made it through my top row. Ugh. That's not fun. Here. Have that. That was a bit awkward. I thought that the... But I should have known, the jumpers do that, they get over these things. So, those are the last three guys in level. And that will be it for this week. Oh, goodness, he's taking a while. Oh, there are two of them. That will be it for this week. Let's collect this part and see what it is. Shoot short range fours at the enemy. It's a puff shroom. So, that's a new plant. It's a weird plant. We haven't seen anything like that. Why is that? Uh-oh. Foreshadowing. Evening, Lost Wolf. Those zombies just won't let up all day. You'll notice that fighting zombies at night is different than in the day. For one, you won't get any sun falling from the sky. You can still get sun from sunflowers, though. And lucky for you, you get to shell some puff shrooms. Plant as many of those as you can, and you will be A-O good. And that is about where I'll end it. So next week, when I see you, we'll start tackling night missions. They're sufficiently different from day missions. And they take a bit of getting used to, so we'll do that. I will see you next week. Thank you so much for watching. I've been Lost Wolf. This is episode 2 of Plants vs. Zombies. Have a great week, everyone. Goodbye.